corner. He holds a professional record, 12 wins, 3 losses. Stands at 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighed in at 63.2 kilograms, fighting out of Karnataka and representing ICSA. Give it up for Kantaraj Kannadiga Agassa! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. His professional record, 6 wins, 1 loss. He stands at 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 60.70 kilograms. Representing Manipur and fighting out of Warriors Cove, he is the MFN interim bantamweight champion, and for a chance to be the MFN champion bantamweight division, the Indian Rhino, Shangren Taran!
Hey gentlemen, you understand the rules, you find. Listen to me, keep yourself protected. If I say stop, please stop. If you want to touch, do it now. God bless you.
Let's get started. This is the main event of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Bantamweight title fight. We've got Kantaraj Agassa, 32 years of age, 165 centimeters in terms of height. He missed weight yesterday and therefore he's not eligible for the title. Against him, we've got 26-year-old MFN interim bantamweight champion, Shangren Taran. I mean, the beauty of the sport is both of them used to train together and now they are face to face.
I mean, the air is thick, my friend, as we get ready for this main event. Kantaraj in the white trunks, Shangren, the interim champion, in the black.
Whoa!
Big left hook, immediately looks for that leg. Interesting strategy by Kantaraj Agassa.
Oh, no strategy at all, man. Take him down. Dude, that's what Kanta does.
Take down the takedown artist.
Yeah. He might get a few shots in, but that's about it. Kanta's going to keep the dominant position.
No, his arm is stuck in a weird way. He's got that leg, but he doesn't have position. He needs to rearrange. He needs to let him back up because he's going to sneak out the back door now. Big elbow to the kidney. Again, Kanta's hips are so good. Has got him pinned up against the cage, and this is an interesting strategy starting out. You can see the way he's grimacing instantly. This is the first time I'm seeing Shangren Taran grimace at the way, and Kanta just slid into side control. Shangren using that headlock, trying to threaten with a guillotine, but to no avail as Kantaraj Agassa takes him to the ground. Shangren getting a little bit of his own medicine here from the last fight, as he did straight what he did to Mohammed Farhad. He's having it done to him by Kantaraj Agassa.
Yeah, Kantaraj has got, like, was born into wrestling, my friend. He came from a wrestling background. He's got a great wrestling skill set.
And the judoka base.
Yeah, and judo as well. So both those combined together is going to be very difficult for Shangren to take it down.
But good job by Shangren Taran bringing it back up to position here.
Yeah, Taran is back on his feet.
And Taran is a tough warrior. We saw him fight and he has no quit in him, but now here's the part, Jason, that we want to discuss. Does that excess weight come into play? Because according to me, it gives him a huge edge in the grappling.
Yeah, he's doing a good job with those knees. Both fighters maintaining good position, a foot stomp.
Very nice foot stomp by Shangren and good inside knee by Kantaraj Agassa. The good thing, the thing about Agassa is that he stays calm, he stays very patient, and he knows while he's got that underhook, he can still turn around.
Right.
I mean, that's his international experience that he's gathered, and he's also a fourth generation wrestler in his family, and you can see here in the cage right now.
But right now, he's landing some very good shots.
I'm super impressed by Corin's ability to grapple with Kantaraj and staying in a dominant position. Get very back nice on his feet, and a nice elbow as they exit the clinch.
Now Kantaraj back to a standing position.
Oh!
He's going to look to open up on the strikes.
That's connected.
That's one area I would say that Shangren has a slight advantage, is the striking.
Yeah, Chungun lands a nice clean shot there against Kanta, gaining his respect, making him stay on the outside and think twice before coming to
the ring. Shots from both fighters, swing and miss. But again, Kanta gets a hold of him. But Chungun this time a little more ready. He's prepared for that shot.
Yeah, because Chungun knows that Kanta's main go-to is to grapple. So he's doing a good job by putting the pressure on and trying to out-grapple Kanta.
Oh, look at this. Look at this. Chungun Koren now putting the pressure on Kanta Rajagasa.
Kanta back on his feet.
And guys, we have to realize this is a 5-round fight. It's going to be, this is a grueling pace to keep. And with that extra weight, he didn't cut weight the right way. And even though he's heavier tonight, he might not be in the greatest shape that he would have liked to be in.
I mean, there's a lot of things that can happen that lead up to a fight. Weight cutting is a big part of it. It does take a lot out of you. So, I mean, I can definitely see he might be feeling the effects of that.
Looking for that. No, but Kanta's still holding onto that kimura there for a defense. But great job by... Man, he's got him down.
Yeah, Koren's did a great job of maintaining the position, not allowing Kanta to get in the groove. But nice reversal by Kanta once again.
Very nice reversal by Kanta Rajagasa. And good, look at that. Great control by Chungun. He broke through the body lock and has got double underhooks of his own now.
And he's got Kanta against the cage, so he's
going to the mat.
I'm very impressed here.
Oh, good hips there. He tried to throw him there. But great hips from Chungun.
Great defense. Recognized the throw coming right away. Defended it great by putting his knee to the ground.
It's going to be an interesting round to score, though, because I think they're even in this. Incredible start.
The main event living it up to the high many expectations.
Hey guys, I'm just so impressed by Koren not being able to be taken down by Kanta, reversing it.
I mean, round started with you know, Kantaraj bullying him a little bit, pushed him up against the cage, landed a shot, surprised him with that takedown. And then once he got a sense of his power, realized that, you know what, I can hang with this guy. I just need to make some adjustments, and boom, he's back. And Koren now looks confident. He knows, you know what, I can still do this. Catches him with that left hook and goes for the takedown, gets it. But the reversals, man, oh man.
I also think that shot that Kanta took coming in kind of rocked him a little bit. And he's also surprised by the fact that Koren is trying to push the pace with the wrestling. He's not really used to being on the defensive side with the wrestling. He's used to being on the offensive side.
Exactly. And now it's going to be interesting to see what strategy they employ, because I think Kanta just can't wade in. You know, Chungun is better. I think Chungun has got a great stand-up game. He's got great hands, and he's got a very solid base. You know, he's short, he's strong, he's tough.
Well, this is a 5-round fight. Round one is over. And it's been an excellent round. I don't know how it's going to turn up in round number two, but if these guys
come
to
wrestling... thank God I'm not a referee.
I think that was just a warm-up round, you guys, for both of you guys.
I mean, we know, I've seen Chungun fight 4 rounds at this pace. He can handle it. But can Kanta Rajagasa maintain that pace for 4 rounds? Again, gets a grip.
Ring with that Superman shot.
There you go.
Kanta looks gassed already to me. I don't know what it is, but his movements seem very sluggish right now.
Labored, I mean, Chungun, though, I've seen him do this for 4 rounds, and now the fact that he realizes that this is his strategy, he's going to lean on Kanta Raj, tire him out. I mean, look at that body lock. He's got an over-under. He's got a grip. And Kanta Raj is trying to get free here.
He's out-wrestling Kanta, 100%.
Yeah, he's currently, he's out-positioning Kanta for sure.
He's got Kanta on the back foot playing defensively, which he's not used to. He's trying to figure out Koren right now. But Koren did a good job of keeping the pressure on, working those knees.
I think Kanta needs to look to, you know, start striking a little more, use his hands, and try and get, you know, hurt him. Because in the first round, I think that left hook surprised him. It hurt him a little
bit. There we go. Another takedown by Koren.
Fantastic.
Not at all what I was expecting.
Nope.
And on the contrary, it's the opposite. I thought Kanta was the same
guy. Exactly.
The same manner he finished Chaitanya.
I mean, this is mount. And in mount position, he needs to be careful. If he doesn't get his hooks in, Kanta is going to slip out the back door.
Yeah, Kanta doing a good
big
job
shots
of fighting it, getting back on his feet.
He smartly realizes that and drags it around. Man, that back control from Chungun is just fantastic. Kanta doing a good job avoiding some of the strikes, that punishment coming that way.
Referee Mark Goddard
survival board right now, trying to get out of a bad spot right now.
Mark Goddard just slaps away Kanta's hand, trying to hold the
cage.
Oh. He needs to watch out for the shot. Oh man,
nice
just
switch.
Ragdolling him.
Nice switch.
Kanta.
Nice ground and pound, putting the pressure on right now.
I mean, those elbows are horrible. Devastating. Vicious. This might end that awesome, you can imagine. Kanta still moving very well. Kanta turning and he's defending himself intelligently. Right in front of us, that too.
Chumrek looking at Mark Goddard.
Mark Goddard asking him to defend himself. And Kanta here is in a bad, bad position. His eye is busted up. You can see he's hurting. Knee to the body and he's just bullying him from this position. He's gonna like, he needs to watch out for the shot to the head.
Referee Mark Goddard talking to
Mark Goddard. He's going to stop this.
Oh. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
I mean, that was
an assault.
That was a bullying. That was an assault. That was just a one-sided beatdown. And we have, ladies and gentlemen, we have a new champion. We have a new bantamweight champion who's unified the belt. And his name is Chumrek Gorin. I mean, Jason, from start to finish, I haven't seen anybody in the history of Indian MMA bully such an accomplished grappler.
I'm shocked. 100% shocked.
Let's look at the action replay here. Chumrek Gorin with pure domination. And the referee Mark Goddard with that stoppage.
I mean, he gave him every shot. He gave him every opportunity to stop the fight. But he gave him every opportunity to step in to do something. And he couldn't handle it. He couldn't. Kanta Rajagasa got out, grappled, out-punched. Outclassed, sadly. I mean, I'm a big fan of Kanta Raj. He's been a very, very big veteran and show of respect. And you can see
Ma'am Aisha Shroff crowning the new bantamweight king at MMA.
Look at that belt, Rao. Look at that belt.
That's beauty. Personified. Oh, man.
And the respect, you know, that's what I'm talking about. It's about sportsmanship and respect between athletes. And the young guy, you can see him crying, man. He's emotional. And if it wasn't for guys like Kanta who paved the way, if it wasn't for guys like Govind, if it wasn't guys like Pawan Maan, Sandeep Dahiya, these guys paved the way for the new brain. And the fact that he respects him for that shows so much class in a champion.
चलिए चलते हैं जारन की तरफ चुमरंग की जीत को औपचारिक करने के लिए.
Ladies and gentlemen, ref Mark Goddard called a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 46 seconds of round 2, declaring the winner. And now, the new MFN bantamweight champion of the world, the Indian Rhino, Chumrek Gorin!
This is my second card in Cumberland, and in my team Warrioscope, और मेरा स्पॉन्सर लोग मसल ब्लेस और एगोस और बहुत सारा मेरा स्पॉन्सरशिप है और ऐसा मैम ने ये बनाया मेरे को खेती का काम बनता है ऐसा मैम ने इतना मेरे को फेमस कराया इतना पैसा दिया है मेरे फ्रेंड मेरा फैमिली बहुत खुश है मैम थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू थैंक यू प्रेस द लॉर्ड थैंक यू जीसस यू गिव मी एवरीथिंग थैंक यू
बिग जंप फॉर कृष्णा और ऐसा मैम गालियां हो जाए इतने सारे लड़कों को इतनी अपॉर्चुनिटी दी है जिंदगी में कुछ कर दिखाने की और जब वो आके इस स्टेज पर ये करते हैं तो ये लोग भी बहुत खुश हो जाते हैं क्योंकि इन्होंने ये किया था सो कंग्रेचुलेशन ब्रदर
और एक सवाल बोलूँगा मेरा पासा से ऐसी के सुनते अदुबो ऐसी पिक खबर जाती कोयरें हरी बचाती है तो नहीं अदुबो आई वो मैं हमें नुस्खे सीधा मणिपुर की लाख पीड़ी बा ऐसी इच्छने ना हो मैं हम ऐसी पोगन फंदे की लाख पीड़ी बा इरहांग मरक सीधा ऐने खल्लू तब क्या यार नंग मैं ऐसी वो पोगन थक पीड़ी बा ऐने खल्ल में ऐसी दिक्कत ना सुले के अदुबो मैं हम लाख ना ऐसी वो थक पीड़ी बा मत या हम ना रहो
जो इनके ट्रांसलेटर अब ट्रांसलेट करेंगे चुंगरेन फील्स अ लॉट फॉर द मणिपुरी स्टेट तो ये इनके ट्रांसलेटर अब ये थोड़ा सा ट्रांसलेट करेंगे
चुंगरेन में आए उन्होंने बोला है कि ही इज फ्रॉम ए स्मॉल कम्युनिटी बट एवरीवन कम्स हियर कम्स आउट एंड सपोर्ट हिम सो ही इज वेरी थैंकफुल टू ईच एंड एवरीवन दैट्स इट ही वांटेड टू रिटर्न द मैसेज
थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू एवरीबॉडी टुनाइट और चुंगरेन जो चैंपियन है तालियां हो जाए यू बीन अ वंडरफुल क्राउड थैंक यू सो मच It really is fantastic. हम सब इतनी मेहनत करते हैं और MMN 15 का ये खत्म हुआ लेकिन ये तो बस शुरुआत है